Sa pang-algebra, tapos na tayo sa trigonometry. We're going to start with algebra, advanced algebra, but first, i-refresh natin yung inyong algebra when you're in your secondary. Okay, so review natin. So, may linear equations tayo. Okay, linear equations may be in terms of one variable, maybe in terms of two variables, in three variables, or the equation may be in terms of literal or literal coefficients, literal quantities. Okay, so isa-isa natin i-review ngayon yan. Okay, and the linear equation in one variable is normally in terms of ax plus c is equal to 0. So we only have one variable x. Okay, so we are going to solve for x. So this one we are going to simplify this equation in terms of this basic equation for a linear equation, ax plus c is equal to 0. So, if you have this equation, 3x minus 4 is 5x plus 8, the only variable that we are going to solve is x. So, what you are going to apply here is normally transposition, division, so let's have this. So we transpose, we combine similar terms. Okay, so similar terms are 3x and 5x. We have the same literal coefficient x. These are constant. So pagsasama-samahin lang natin, we transpose quantities. So if we transpose 5x to the side of the equation, magiging negative 5x siya. Okay, transposition yun. Remember, class, an equation is equation ay may rung dalawang algebraic expression na sinaseparate ang quality sign. Equation yun, when you solve for the variable. So, we transpose 5x, we transpose 4. So, this is, napagsama natin yung similar terms. These quantities have x. Ito ay constant. So, 3x minus 5x is minus 2x. 8 plus 4 is 12. Divide both sides by negative 2. So, negative 2 divided by negative 2. We use the principle of cancellation. So, this becomes negative over negative is positive x. 12 divided by negative 2 is negative 6. So, that is the value of the variable x, negative 6. So, pwede naman nyo siyang check. You just substitute the value of x na nakuha mo to our original equation. So, this is 3 times negative 6 minus 4 is equal to 5 times negative 6 plus 8. So, negative 22, negative 30 plus 8 is negative 22. The left and the right side of the equation are the same. Okay, let's have another example of simultaneous equations. This time, two equations involving two unknowns, x and y, okay, but in fraction form, okay? So, pwede natin i-solve yung x and y, okay? So, let's have this. By elimination, multiply equation 1 by negative 2, then add to equation 2. So, pangalanan natin ito, this is equation 1, this is equation 2. So, sabi nyo lang, multiply lang natin equation 1 by negative 2. So, this is, lahat na ito, by negative 2. So, this is negative 4 over x. And positive, negative times negative is positive 18 over y. Negative 2 times 2 is negative 4. Okay? And then negative 4 over x plus 4 over x is cancel. So, eliminated na siya. Okay? So, we have 18 over y plus negative 3 over y is 18 minus 3 is 15 over y. Negative 4 plus 3 is negative 1. Then by cross multiplication, we have negative y is 15. So multiplying both sides by negative 1, we have y is equal to negative 15. So yun ang isang ating answer for the variable y. So since y is known, pwede na tayo mag-substitute dito sa kahit saan dito. So i-choose natin equation 2, substitute our y. So, 4 over x is negative 3 over y, which is negative 15, is equal to 3. So solving for, so this becomes negative over negative is positive, 1 over 5. Reducing to the lowest terms, this is 3 over 15 is 1 over 5. Nilipad natin doon, magiging negative. So this becomes 4 over x is equal to 3 minus 1/5. That is equal to, simplifying. So we simplify, we multiply by 5. Okay? By 5 para mawala yun. So we solve for x. X is 10 over 7. So ayun yung pagsusimplify na. Okay, the arrow states how it is simplified. So, meron ka ng x at meron ka ng y. So, your solution set is xy, okay? 10 over 7 and negative 15. Ngayon, para sa checking, you can use any of these two equations and substitute your xy para makita mo kung tama. So, from equation 1, 2 over x, x natin is 10 over 7, minus 9 over y, and y is negative 15, must be equal to 2. So this is simplified as 14 over 10. This is negative over negative 9 over 15. 14 over 10 is 7 over 5. 3 over 9 over 15 is 3 over 5 is equal to 2. Okay? So 7 plus 3, same denominator. 7 plus 3 is 10 over 5 is equal to 2. So that checks. Okay. So linear equation in one variable kanina, two variables. So, tatlo na yung variables natin dito, x, y, and z. And three equations din. Okay? So, kamukha kanina, okay, pangalanan natin yung ating mga equations. So, this is equation 1, equation 2, equation 3. By elimination, we choose one pair, isang pair. So, pwedeng 1, 2, pwedeng 1, 3, pwedeng 2, 3. So, the first pair is 1, 2. Yung muna yung ating pilingin. Equations 1 and 2, piliin natin yung variable na i-eliminate. So, mas madaling i-eliminate between 1 and 2, mas madaling i-eliminate yung z. Kasi pag, okay, let's add 1 and 2. So, x plus y plus z is 6. 3x plus 2y minus z is 6. So, adding similar terms, x plus 3x is 4x, y plus 2y is 3y, z minus z, eliminated na siya. So, by elimination, we have, okay, we have now another equation, pangalanan natin equation 4, dalawa na may variable, okay, x and y. And then, we choose another pair, we choose another pair, kung in-eliminate natin yung z, ito sa susunod natin pipiliin na pares, z din ang i-eliminate natin. So, okay, we choose equations 2 and 3, itong dalawang to. Ito ang eliminate natin, yung z pa rin. So, paano natin mag-eliminate? We multiply equation 2 by 2. Okay? Equation 2 is multiplied by 2. So, ito ay magiging 6x, 4y, minus 2z is equal to 12. Ito na ngayon yung equation 2. Then, i-add natin siya sa equation 3. Ang 3 natin ay 2x, minus y, plus 2z is 6. And then, okay, add natin. Mag-add na tayo. So, 6 plus 2 is 8, plus 4 minus y is plus 3, minus 2 plus 2 is cancelled, ulit-ulit, eliminated, 12 plus 6 is 18. So, again, meron tayong panglimang equation in terms of x and y, in terms of x and y. So, balik lang tayo dun sa previous samples natin. We have simultaneous equations in two unknowns, x and y. So, elimination ulit. So, we have now equation 4 and equation 5. Mas madali eliminate yung y. 4x, 8x, 3y, 3y. So, madali eliminate. So, paano mo eliminate yung y? Kailangan, multiply mo yung equation 4, this one, by negative 1. So, ito ay magiging negative 4x, negative 3y, negative 12. Then, yet natin equation 5, 8x plus 3y is equal to 18. So, adding, minus 4 plus 8x is 4x minus 3 plus 3. Again, magka-cancel. Minus 12 plus 18 is 6. Divide both sides by 4. By 4. So, we have x is equal to 6 over 4 or 3 halves. Okay? Paano ngayon natin susolve yung y? So, meron ka ng x. pwede ka nang pumunta sa equation 4. Okay? Substitute natin yung x. 4 times 3 halves plus 3y is 12. So, this is 4 divided by 2 is 2 times 3 is 6 plus 3y is 12. Lipat natin yung 6. It's 12 minus 6. Y is equal to 2. So, meron ka ng x and y. Pagyari man, dahil x and y ka na, any of these three equations ang pwede mong gamitin to solve for the remaining variable z. Okay? So, sa equation 1, x plus y plus z is equal to 6. Alam na natin yung x, 3 halves. Alam na natin yung y is 2. Z is unknown. So, you solve for z, that is 5 halves. So, your solution set, x, y, z is x, y, z. Ayan na siya. Then you check any of the three equations. So, equation 3 ang gamitin natin. 2x, 2 times 3 halves. Ayan. Minus y, ang y natin is 2, plus 2z, yung z natin is 5 halves, must be equal to 6. So, 2 times 3 halves, ka-cancel yun ang 2, matitira yung 3. Minus 2, 2 times 5 halves, cancel yung 2, 5. 3 plus 5 is 8, minus 2 is 6, it's also equal to 6. So, check.